My name is Shahed Ahmed and I'm head teacher here at Elmhurst Primary School. We're a big fourth form entry school in the East End of London in Forest Gate, and I've been a head teacher here for quite a few years. And our journey to mastery started 2 to 3 years ago when I was first asked to accompany the school's Minister of Education to go to Shanghai in China to find out what it was that was helping Shanghai to be so good in mathematics. Before we went, many of us were somewhat skeptical. I think there were, you know, some stereotypes that we thought the reason why they were doing so well was because there was a lot of rote learning, a lot of memorization. But actually, once we were there and we watched lessons and we spoke to teachers and to children, nothing could have been further from the truth. They taught in a very clear way, step by step, really deepening learning, not going too fast, and this is what we mean by mastery teaching. So it's step-by-step learning, breaking the teaching down into much smaller steps in a way that the children can then really understand what the mathematics is with practice and deepening. And we found that by teaching in this way that we saw in Shanghai, the children were able to understand each step and consolidate very, very well. So it meant that, for example, that the teachers were able to concentrate on fewer topics, mostly number, especially when they're younger. And then because the foundation is so strong, they're able then to speed up once the children get a bit older into secondary school. So from that visit sprung the idea of having math hubs across the country. And the idea of math hubs is that they are centres of excellence for mathematics, so the teaching of mathematics is really good in those schools, in primary schools and secondary schools. And then those math hubs then support schools within quite a wide locality, quite a wide geographical area, to provide CPD, to provide the support and expertise to help bring about the teaching of mastery, teaching in mathematics in those schools. The teaching that we saw and the setup that we saw in Shanghai was that the classes were mixed ability, they weren't set. And before I went out to China, the way that we used to organise our teaching here was that we would set the children into ability sets. So that was something that we've changed now, so that now we have mixed ability until year three, and then just partial ability setting, not full ability setting, from year fours, five and six. And that, I think, has really meant that the lower ability children and the gaps are beginning to shorten. And that the children are being able to access some of the more complex ideas that maybe we might have put a ceiling on previously with the strict setting that we used to have. And the other feature is that in Shanghai, although the subject knowledge of the teachers is excellent, I mean, many of them have a mathematics background, academic background themselves, they still use very good textbooks to support the teaching. So we looked at a number of textbooks here and we chose one particular scheme, one particular textbook, and we've trained our teachers in using those textbooks in a sensitive way, so not slavishly, but in a sensitive way, so that they have the subject knowledge and the framework to be able to then break the mathematics down into much smaller steps and to really deepen the questioning and deepen the learning so that children really get each step of mathematics and they don't move on too fast where they have weak foundations. It's much slower, step by step, with really deepening questioning so that the depth of the knowledge is much greater and therefore their grasp of mathematics and mathematical concepts is much better.